I'd like you to close your eyes and imagine this. Wake up, rush to class, listen to the teacher explain something, take notes, practice what you've learned. The free time you do have is spent doing homework or maybe quickly running to Einstein's if you're lucky. Not too hard to imagine a typical day at Wayland High School because it's the lives that most of us live every single day. For those of you with your eyes still closed, you can open them. But now I'd like you to imagine this. Wake up, run 5 miles, or free dive through a coral tunnel at 65 feet. Then you go to class, but class isn't behind a desk. Class is 70 feet below water, and you're actually seeing and experiencing what you're learning. This is what I did at the Island School, a semester-long program in Cape Eleuthera, Bahamas, filled with amazing opportunities and a new and different education. It was hard going from steady, stable, and unchanging Wayland to a place where it felt like they squeezed 28 hours into a 24-hour day. So, as I stood around the flagpole and gazed at these 50 strangers who would unknowingly be my best friends by the end of it all, I realized before I left, I was a zombie, just going through the motions. I wasn't awake or aware of my surroundings, or rather, what went beyond them. The academics were tough, and at times felt relentless with a six-day school week. I know what many of you may be thinking, that I went on a sunny beach vacation for 4 months, but not even close. The classes and schoolwork were piled high. Now I want to take you halfway through the program, and I found myself alone, my stomach grumbling. And the harsh sun beating down on my face. For 2 nights and 2 days, with just a bagel, was one of, if probably not, the most insane eye-opening challenges of my life. I may have sat there for hours, starving and talking to myself, but it allowed me time to reflect, think, write, and grow. I was alive and aware, and in taking advantages of all of my opportunities, no matter how difficult they were. On solo, we were given a journal to write down our thoughts, and it kept me from going truly insane. So I'd like to read you something from it. No, really. Why don't they give us more food? I get 2 days, alone, no tent, just a tarp. That I can handle. But one bagel, a block of cheese, an orange, and a handful of warp for 2 days? Hell no, I get thirds for almost every meal in the dining hall. I can't handle this. I don't know what time it is, but I'm so hungry, and I'm frying off my skin. I need to be picked up right now. Can these people please come save me? Now, please. Yep, that was pretty dramatic. But at the time, it's how I felt. And getting through that only made me stronger. But solo wasn't just a time when I was hungry and angry. It was also a time that I realized what leaving Wayland High School had done for me. I wrote this on the last day of solo. But truly and honestly, this place has made me realize how great of a life I have with my family, friends, and community. Times get rough, and it sucks, but I'm here living and experiencing and taking chances. I think that it took stepping out of my community and my place to see where I am, where I come from, and who I'll be, and I know I can do it. Solo was a challenge, the ultimate challenge for me. I wasn't scared of bugs or bad guys finding me or anything else that could have wandered onto my temporary home for those 2 days. But I was scared. I was scared of where my mind would take me. I had time, so much time, to think of anything and everything that crossed my mind. I was scared that when I woke up in the middle of the night and the moon was in the same spot that it had been the last time I woke up, that I would never make it these 2 days, let alone till morning. I was scared, but when I wanted to give up, I didn't. Challenges were not treated as obstacles or inconvenient tasks to complete so you could move on to the next. Challenges are opportunities. As psychologist Albert Bandura conducted studies on the role of self-belief and how people approach goals, tasks, and challenges, what he found was that a person's view of their own ability directly influences their success, both in achieving aspirations as well as overcoming challenges. What does that mean? It means that challenges will give you confidence, and that confidence will allow you to meet new challenges. So what will you do? I'm not telling you to go spend the next 48 hours alone on a beach with just a bagel, or to go to another country, because that might not be what your challenge is or what you're interested in. I'm wondering, how can you step out of this mold that has been so nicely shaped for us? This mold of school, friends, sports, and homework. Just step out of the same routine. Don't do anything just because you think it will help you get into college. Do something because you think it will help you in college or beyond that. We are part of a generation that wants more and wants the best of everything. But what really is the best? What's waiting for you? There's more to life than what you see right in front of you. And allowing yourself to experience that will open up so many doors. What's waiting for you? I can tell you, an unbelievable amount of confidence and pride. Never in my life did I think I'd be able to do anything like this, from solo to running, to even just being away from home and being surrounded by completely different people. But I did it. I thought I wasn't good enough. I wasn't strong enough. And accomplishing this has brought me to a place where I feel happy and courageous in anything that comes my way. Today, when faced with a challenge, I know I can do it, because even just doing one thing I never thought I could has given me the confidence to do so many more things I never thought possible. I changed my routine and stepped out of the mold, and that has defined who I am today. So I just have one question for you. How will you step out of yours? Thank you.